During Gamescom, I took the time to record all the skills from the Assassin's Creed Origins skill line. I will show them all and explain them all in this video. First, of course, it's important to know that there are three different playstyles that you can focus on. Warrior for melee attacks, ranged for stealth and bow attacks, and the Seer for traps and taming animals. Let's start with the skills for the Warrior. Let's start with Overpower, since this is a skill that will be enhanced by many Warrior abilities. If you watch my previous video showing all the Overpower attacks per weapon, then you already know what this is. So yeah, every weapon has a super or an Overpower attack that you can do if your adrenaline meter is full. And these attacks are super powerful and can instantly kill a target. And this is also the first skill you will unlock for the Warrior line. Then let's move over to the first ability that enhances this Overpower attack, and that's the Overpower XP ability, meaning that you get extra XP if you kill someone with your Overpower attack. The Overpower XP ability was a passive attack, so that means that it's always active, while the Overpower Chain Throw is an active ability that lets you throw the enemy's weapon at another target. So an enemy dies, you throw that weapon to your next target. Really cool. The Overpower Combo ability lets you jump onto a target and then do light attacks right after that, and during my Gamescom demo I did not have that active, so I jumped onto a target with an overpower attack from the dual blades, but I could not do extra damage while he was on the ground. Well, with this skill you can. Weapon Bearer is another skill I think you should get like really early on in the game. This lets you switch between two weapons on the fly and in combat. So if you see, oh, this enemy is great against the weapon I'm using now, switch it up and then you can attack again. The attack and push ability is nice for if you are fighting on a high structure to push enemies off. After a light attack, you can push the enemies. Extend Combo, as the description reads, lets you do one more melee attack before the enemy can recover, so great for fighting. Kill Loot is great for 3 ability points. It lets you loot the enemy after a melee attack, so it's worth noting that this is not for an assassination kill, so a stealth kill, because there's another skill in the Hunter's line for that. Instantly looting is of course great, so you don't miss anything. Then we go to Adrenaline 1, a really interesting one where you get half of your adrenaline bar at the start of a fight already, so you can easily build up more adrenaline to do an overpower attack. There's also Adrenaline 2 that lets you instantly have a full adrenaline bar to unleash hell on your enemies. This seems pretty overpowered in my opinion, having almost an instant kill right away, but nice skill, I would get it. Adrenaline will be used for the ability Shield Charge, where you run up to an enemy, bash them on the ground and simply throw them off a cliff. Want to play Assassin's Creed Origins a little bit GTA style? Well, then you need the Hijack skill from the Warrior skill line to pull enemy drivers off their mounts and take it. A nice way to get a camel early on without having to buy one. The parry ability is, as the name suggests, while in shield mode you can deflect the enemy and deal damage and create an opening. Then we got Overpower Ultra, back to the overpower attacks, and this makes the damage of the overpowering attacks increased by 2. So if you got a full adrenaline meter at the start of the battle and fight against the boss 1v1, instantly doing a ton of damage. It is really, really powerful. With the Charge Heavy Attack ability, it lets you hold onto your heavy attack and unleash it to shield break the target and throw enemies on the ground. Another passive is Regeneration. Your life can regenerate during combat, so great during a fight if you try to run away or hide from an enemy, it regenerates your health as well. Then we got Air Attack. If you played Horizon, then you kinda can compare this with Strike from above, so jumping and doing an assassination, of course also present in the previous AC games. Last but not least is the Master Note for the Warrior that gives you an extra percent melee damage, but the trick is that you can keep pumping ability points into that one, so it's a great ability to keep upgrading at the max level to still become more powerful with melee attacks. Let's move over to the Zeer specialization. Like I said, more focused on traps and animal taming, but also some shop things. It's pretty interesting. For example, the first skill here is Smoke Screen. After melee hit, you can roll away, stunning the enemies, so it's great for causing confusion, but also great for causing damage if you follow it up with a Smoke Screen damage ability, so enemies will then take damage and be knocked to the ground by a smoke screen. Prefer using fire arrows, then you can get the Pyromaniac skill to increase your fire damage by 50%. Also handy for the Firebombs ability that you can unlock, one of the skills that will set the enemies ablaze. This is one of my favorite skills and one that I totally will be getting really soon, and that's Animal Taming. If you put an animal to sleep, you will be able to tame them and have them follow you around, probably attacking enemies as well. So you need a sleeping dart for that, and that's also an ability that you can unlock. Interesting to note is that they need to be a lower rank than you to be able to make them asleep. And in the case of the animals, to tame them. So the lion you want to tame has to be a lower level than you. You also have potion darts as an active ability, dealing damage over time to the enemy. Breath holding champion lets you go underwater for longer. And this one, Berserk, is also pretty cool. If you sneak up to an unaware target, you can turn it against its allies with this ability. This is really the seer at its best. This ability, Flesh Decay, lets you constimate nearby enemies by using the skill on a dead body. Pretty awesome stuff. The first seer ability you'll be getting is the call mount ability that will let you call your mount. So when you get lost, you want to be on a mount, just do this ability and the mount will come. Salesman is nice to get some extra cash from animal goods and trinkets. And I think that trinkets and maybe the animal goods as well are like only items you have to sell at stores to get some money. Sun Increase is really nice. Buy materials is nice if you're interested in crafting. With this you can now buy crafting materials at a store. There are three types of mounts in Assassin's Creed Origins: horses, camels, and chariots. To buy war chariots, you need to get this ability. Backstore upgrades the store as well, but interesting is that I could already buy rare items in my playthrough at the blacksmith or outfit shop without having that skill. So maybe that was for the demo, I really don't know. If you're planning to do a lot of seer abilities, then you want the tool kill XP ability to get extra XP for doing so. With the dawn and dusk ability, you can change the time. So if you don't like that it's dark right now, you can change it to a sunny weather. Then to round the seer out, we of course have the master note. Just like with the master warrior, this one increases the damage by 1% and can be used more than once. Let's move over to the last section of the skill line or ability line from Assassin's Creed Origins. Let's go to the hunter. Starting with eagle tagging, of course you have your eagle Senu that you can use. With eagle tagging, you can make him tag enemies and other points of interest. Are you great at giving headies that deal, by the way, a ton of damage in Assassin's Creed Origins, as you see right here? Well, it also gives you extra XP if you have this skill. Want extra XP for assassinating targets? Then you need the assassination XP ability to increase your XP for killing enemies while they don't see you. Speaking of assassination, chain assassination is kind of a combo of the overpowered chain throw and the assassination skill, where you also throw the enemy's weapon at another target, but this time after you assassinated them. Are you really going to go full stealth with stealth kill streak? You get extra XP for your chain kill assassinations. In the warrior line we got kill loot, and in the hunter line we got assassination loot, and it's like the same. Here, if you assassinate a target, you will instantly loot it. This ability is really cool, so if enemies shoot arrows at you, you block them with your shield and you can exactly get them into your own inventory. So normally when you shoot, you get arrows from their dead bodies. Now you can just block enemies shooting arrows at you, use those arrows against them. Bow bearer is kind of the same as the weapon bearer from the warrior skill line, making you able to equip two bows and switch between them. There are four types of bows in Assassin's Creed Origins, so being able to switch in combat between a sort of shotgun bow called the warrior bow for close range and the sniper predator bow for a long range is just great. In the hunter skill line you also see a lot of announcements for Senu. This skill makes him stun the enemy if you look at them and press a button, but also cool that he might show up during a fight to harass your enemy. Then we also got four bow announcements for every type of bow. Light bows get an increased stability. This one is weird, I think we saw this in the first gameplay reveal as well. Being able to control a predator arrow in the air, like going off the stairs and stuff like that. Pretty weird, but that's the announcement for the predator bow. The announced hunter bow lets you charge your attack and then break a shield so you can follow up with a nice melee attack or continue shooting with this bow. And the announced warrior bow upgrade makes the dispersion zone less, so you can easily hit all the arrows from the shotgun on one target. Senu can do more stalking. With the hunter's instinct ability, you can see the path of the enemies or civilians that they're currently taking. Bow Fury, really cool. It lets you get two kills. So after a stealth kill, you for example shoot one with your predator bow, then you kind of have a slow motion and you can immediately kill another target more easily after that. Want to do more slow motion? Well, with the elite ranger, it gives you a slow motion in the air. Then of course, to finish it off with the hunter master note, it gives you 1% extra damage to all your bows. Again, you can keep adding to it with more ability points, so you can, like, in the end, have 200 plus damage or 200% extra damage, which of course are really great. Overall, I think the skill line in Assassin's Creed Origins is really good. Every skill has something interesting, good for certain playstyles, and I think I will go for a combination of the Warrior and the Seer to begin with, and then later unlock all the Hunter abilities as well. But there are a lot of fun ones that I want to get right away. What do you think of the skill line of Assassin's Creed Origins? Let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe for way more Assassin's Creed Origins as we near launch, beyond, but also right now, as I got a ton of videos about the game up on the channel with an awesome armor, and also all the overpowered attacks and just way more. So totally check it out on the channel. Like the video if you did. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will speak to you next time. Goodbye.